Created true brotherhood, true unity, and they were Muslims. And they could be proud to stand up as a Muslim nation, as an ummah. Are we living their legacy or not? Mus'ab bin Umair was a youngster. He was from a noble and prestigious family. He wore the most expensive attire. He applied the best of the fragrance. He was known amongst the youth of Makkah. The people would give an example of Mus'ab. If you wanted to see someone with glamour, beauty, style, fashion, look at Mus'ab. He's smart, he's clever, he's intelligent, he's wealthy. He was from upper and he was from the upper class. However, the call of Islam came. He accepted Islam. He was imprisoned by his own family, by his parents. He fled and he took refuge in Abyssinia. And then he went to Medina. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had not migrated to Medina yet. And he began calling the people to Islam. Until he was martyred in the Battle of Badr. This man who would change his garments and clothes every day, who lived in the palace of Mecca, who wore and applied the best of fragrance, people aspired to be like him, is now drenched in his own blood, and he doesn't even have sufficient amount of cloth to cover his body. If the cloth is used to hide his feet, then his face and his head becomes uncovered. And when they cover his face with the shroud, then his feet become uncovered. He, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then covered his face and then used grass to cover his feet. He sacrificed his home, his family, his riches, the comfort, the youth, due to the sake of Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Where is the Mus'ab of today? The Mus'ab of today is chasing the very life he had. We all aspire to look smart, to wear the best of garments, to drive beautiful cars, to live in a beautiful house. When this was never a trait of an ummati. An ummati was who? For whom love came before any material goods. Love for Allah, love for messenger, love for people. Abu Bakr radiallahu an had 80,000 dirhams before he accepted Islam. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam announces a battle and he's collecting money. Umar radiallahu an says, I will surely outbeat Abu Bakr today. And he brings half his riches. Then Abu Bakr comes, radiallahu an, and he brings the riches he has, the wealth he has, the money he has. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam asks him, oh Abu Bakr, what remains for you at home? He says, nothing but Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And when he departs from this world, he doesn't have a single dirham or dinar to his name. Sa'id ibn Zayd radiallahu an was appointed the governor of Homs, which is in Syria. Umar radiallahu an, the caliph of the time, he proposed a fixed salary for him. But Sa'id ibn Zayd, he's the governor of Homs, he refuses. Even as a governor, a ruler, the fire in his house would not lit up to cook any food. Many days passed by without any food being cooked in his home. Because a sense of responsibility for fellow human beings How would I respond to Allah's question? You are an ummati, you are blessed with iman, and there were people oppressed. They did not have a garment to cover their modesty with. They didn't have a morsel to put in their mouths. What role did you play? You claim to love me. You claim to love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But أنت تظهر حبه. You claim and you express their love. But where is the proof of the love? Upon hearing the poor conditions, Umar radiallahu an sent a bag full of dinar. Sa'id radiallahu an, he threw it away and he appeared distressed. And his wife asked him, what has happened to you? Is it a calamity that the leader has passed away of the believers, the Amir al-Mu'mineen? He replies, this calamity is greater than the death of the Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers. Is it that the Muslims have been defeated in the battlefield? He replies, this calamity is greater than the defeat of the Muslims. What is this great calamity? He says, the world has entered into my home in order to ruin my akhirah. He asks his wife whether she will assist him in removing this calamity. She responds in the affirmative. He takes the bag and he spends each and every dinar on the poor and needy, and he does not return home until the bag is completed, until the bag is empty. Umar radiallahu anhu then comes to Hims. The people of Hims complain to Umar radiallahu anhu about their governor Sa'id bin Zayd. And they say, we have three complaints about Sa'id bin Zayd. First is, he delays in coming to us in the morning. Secondly, he does not respond to us at night. Thirdly, each month there is a day wherein he does not leave his home, and the entire day he remains at home. And there is also something that time to time he loses consciousness. Umar radiallahu anhu summons him. You are the governor. These people are complaining that you delay in coming to them. You do not respond to them at night. Each month there is a day when you do not come to them at all. You lose your consciousness time to time. Why is it this? Beautifully, Sa'id ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu says, firstly, I do not come unto them in the early morning. He says, Wallah, inni kuntu al-akrahu dhikrahu, laysa li wa li-ahli khadim. By Allah, I did not want to reveal this before anyone, but you are the Amir al-Mu'mineen. You are asking me, and I am obliged to answer to you. That me and my wife, our household, do not have a servant. فَأَعْجِنُ عَجِينِي ثُمَّ أَجَلِسُ حَتَّى يَخْتَمِرُ ثُمَّ أَخْبِزُ خُبْزِي. That I wake up in the early morning, I plow and knead my dove, I wait for it and then make my own bread, my own provisions, and thereafter I perform ablution and then I come to resolve the affairs of the believers. Then Umar radiallahu anhu asked him, why do you not come to them at night? Why do you not respond to them at night? He says, I do not come to them at night. Inni kuntu la'akrahu dhikra. Verily, I do not want to reveal it to others, but I feel obliged to respond to you. Inni ja'altu an-nahara lahum wal layla lahu 'azza wa jal. I have made my days for the people, and I have made my entire night for the Creator. Then he responds, thirdly, I don't come out to them one day of the month. Why? لَيْسَ لِي خَادِمْ يَغْسِلُ ثِيَابِي وَلَا لِي ثِيَابِ. He says, I do not have any servants to wash my clothes, and I only have one single garment. And I wash it once a month. I cannot leave the home without it drying up, since I have no other garment to cover my modesty. Then he says, fourthly, I fall unconscious from time to time, because I witnessed the scene of the people of Makkah when they hung Khubayb ibn Adi. Each time I recall the scene of the martyrdom of Khubayb radiallahu anhu, I fall unconscious because I fear Allah will not forgive my sins, because I did not protect Khubayb in any way. I did not stand up for justice when Khubayb was unjustly crucified. Who was Khubayb? How was he crucified? He was captured by the people of Makkah. He was dragged, and the people had assembled. They were cheering. They were mocking him. They were throwing their rubbish at him. He was nailed into a piece of wood, and his body was mutilated. His flesh was cut open whilst he was awake. He was sliced limb by limb in the state of consciousness. His enemies mocked him, that you are a believer, you are Muslim. Here, this is the consequence of your iman. أَتُحِبُّ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدْ مَكَانَكْ. Would you wish that Muhammad is in your place and you remain in the comfort of your family? They ridiculed him. But he replied, والله ما أحب أني في أهلي وولدي وأن محمدا أشيك بشوكة. He says, by Allah, I do not for a single second, for a single moment, wish my life is spared. I rest with my family. I live in comfort, in enjoyment. And Muhammad, peace be upon him, is prickled even by a single thorn. This is his aspiration, his desire, his love for Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Muhammad is prickled even by a single thorn. No, I will leave my luxuries, because he's dearer to me. An-Nabiyu awla bil-mu'mineen min anfusihim. The Prophet should be more dearer to you than your own selves. Is my Prophet more dearer? Or do I cast away, shun away his sunnats? When I am at school, college, university, workplace, shopping mall, on the street, with my children, siblings, parents, spouses, work colleagues, friends, is it the Muhammad who comes first, sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Or is it the pressure of my society? Is it the peer pressure? Is it the media? Is it the temptation? Is it my luxuries? Or it is the word of Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam?